I've been having a lot of somatic hallucinations lately, and these are things that you feel that aren't there, and it's really strange, and it really messes with your head. But they usually follow a pattern to where I have a headache, and then all of a sudden these sensations will like flood throughout my body and my brain and stuff. Like one time, I thought there was a snake in my head. I didn't tell anybody that. I know better than to tell people what I'm thinking, but I did walk around for a while. I'm like, maybe they put a snake in my head. And I don't know, I kind of like halfway believed it. But what happens is when I hallucinate, it makes me react in ways that are crazy. Like I used to run around screaming and stuff, and other things that were bad, but I don't do that so much anymore, because I'm like, I've gotten used to it as I progress. One of the bad things about somatic hallucinations is that when you tell your doctor the symptoms, a lot of times they will be concerned about you and think that you're having something bad happen to you when you're not. What I really need to do is get a blood pressure cuff so that I don't freak out myself, because a couple nights ago I was literally freaking out about this. And I need to just check my blood pressure and make sure it's normal, and then tell myself it's okay. I mean, if there's ever an abnormal reading, then I'll know that I need to go somewhere. But I don't like wasting people's time, and I don't like going to the ER because, like, I feel bad about it because there are a lot of very sick people, and I'm like, I don't really need to be here. This is just really strange, and like, you know, I'm not going to tell them that I think I have a snake in my head, but because that'll just get me locked up on the ward, which is a waste too. I try to avoid waste as much as I can. I am happy that they did an MRI though, because I kind of have wanted to know that for a while. Just kind of to check on a couple other things to make sure that, okay, a couple of times when I've been psychotic, I've slammed my head against things, and I just wanted to make sure there wasn't any damage. So I'm happy that they did that and there wasn't any damage, so I'm good to go. Because when I was hearing voices really bad one time, let me explain, I went absolutely crazy because they will drive you nuts for a while, like before you figure out that they're not real and they can't do anything, and then you've kind of like talked yourself out of them. Okay, well before that, I would get really, really irritated with them, and I was like, I know how I'll make them shut up. And it was just like, you know, yeah, don't do that. So I've also had several head injuries throughout my life, but they've not been anything substantial. I just wanted to make sure that they were nothing substantial, and they weren't. So I'm glad that they did that. I try to, again, avoid the psych ward and the hospital and stuff because I don't feel like I'm that bad anymore. But boy, we've had our days in the ER, trust me. Or I've had my days in there. I feel so bad when I see those people come in. I'm like, they are so sick, and there's probably not a lot. I mean, they can do some stuff, but they're still going to have problems for the rest of their lives. As far as, again, somatic hallucinations go, I just have to learn how to deal with them a little better, besides freaking out. And I really need to learn not to ask other people what my symptoms are, because they will tell me that, like, okay, for instance, when you're schizophrenic, you will slur your words a lot of times, like, you'll be like, blah, blah, blah. It's weird, I don't know why it happens, but it does happen to me periodically. People will be like, you're having a stroke, and it's like, no, I'm not having a stroke, this is just schizophrenia again. So, my thinking will get blurred and weird and stuff, and it's just schizophrenia. So, I don't know. Again, I just need a blood pressure cuff or something. Oh, well.